I touch, but it ain't real. They say I move too fast, going man to man, always holding a new hand.
He would kiss me, he would touch me like I need. Drake would leave me, he would keep me, never break his promises. I'd be the best he ever had, he'd be on his best behavior.
Hollywood, go. Go. Hey, Hollywood. Hey, Hollywood, go. Go.
All right. Today is Monday. Music Monday coming around again at www.poeticexpressions.com. Thank you all for watching these videos week after week. If you haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel, make sure you go ahead and do that before you finish watching this video. And today we are talking about J. Cole and K. Michelle. So first up, we'll talk about J. Cole a little bit. I do have a full review called J. Cole Takes the Crown at my website, www.poeticexpressions.com, basically going over my thoughts on his new CD, which seemed to pop up out of nowhere because I'm a J. Cole fan and don't really remember hearing any big buzz about him doing a new CD, especially for release by the end of this year. So he really doesn't have any high profile guests this time, which I thought was pretty interesting because he's worked with everyone from TLC to Missy to Jay-Z. I mean, some really big artists that he's worked with, and on this CD he doesn't have any guest features at all. But it's great music. He produced it pretty much all himself, like he does his previous work. Of course, he writes all of his music. And I think he's really getting back to the true artistry of hip-hop. And I think that he's doing this while many other people are recognizing it as well, as he's set to bump Taylor Swift from the number one spot on the Billboard Top 200 Albums chart coming up this week. So he's projected to sell about 360,000 copies, which is pretty huge considering all of the downloading and, you know, ripping people to do it music these days. And if he does get those numbers, this will be his biggest sales week ever of his career. So congratulations to him on that. Again, check out J. Cole Takes the Crown at www.poeticexpressions.com. Now, on to K. Michelle. K. Michelle, her new CD, Anybody Wanna Buy a Heart, is also set to put up some pretty big numbers this week. So big that she is only the second or third female R&B artist to sell over 100,000 copies in a given week this year. So that just goes to show that record sales are truly down. No one is really buying albums as much as they used to in the 90s, where you heard of people, you know, going diamond in album sales. It's just pretty much unheard of now. So congratulations to her on that. That is definitely a feat that is rare to be achieved. But I will say that with the album cover, which if you've not seen it, she's basically naked on the cover. She's kneeling down and her hair is kind of, I guess, over her head, hanging down. And when you open the CD, anybody that has this CD, yeah, I don't even really know what to say. But I will say that she's naked in all of the artwork for the CD. And for the most part, I would say it's tastefully done. She has roses covering up vital parts, if you will, of her body. And she looks good. I mean, you can't take it away from her. I mean, her body looks nice. And I really can't even say that the pictures look that photoshopped, really. It looks like, for the most part, it's really her. So, but I will say that in this day and age, she's smart and she knows that sex sells. And I think that's what she's really selling here with this album. The first single, Love 'Em All, where she's basically talking about being with all these different men, and she really doesn't necessarily love any of them. And she's using one man to get over the next one. I like the song, but when you really get down to the message of what it's saying, it's like, do you know, that's something that we really want to be putting out there. But hey, who am I? She's making music and making millions, so who am I to say what she should be singing about? Also, another standout track, which is a new single. It's called Maybe I Should Call. She's talking about a guy who she's been involved with, who's obviously in a relationship who has now gotten married, and not only that, is expecting a child, and she's wondering, where does she fit into this whole scenario? So that song is pretty good too, I would say. She has some good songs on here. I would say of the whole CD, which there's about 14 tracks, I would say half of them are really good. Which to me doesn't necessarily equate a solid CD. I think she could have honestly done without three or four of the tracks on here and presented a better CD. I do like her first one, Rebellious Soul, a lot better than I like this one, I will say that. Just some of the subject matter here, I'm just really not into one song in particular. I played a clip of it in my intro. It's called Drake Will Love Me. Yes, Drake the rapper, that's who she's talking about, and she's saying she's such a good woman that Drake would never leave her and he would always kiss her and just love her forever. Yeah. All right. So moving on. she has another song on here called Build a Man, which is, the song itself is okay, and I actually could see it being picked out as a single. But she's really kind of comparing having a man to building one, like Build-A-Bear. I don't know if you all remember those, used to be really popular, but she's kind of comparing this guy that she wishes she had to that. So lyrically, I'll just say this CD overall really disappointed me, just point blank it did. I was expecting more from her. I think that she had much more lyrical content on the first CD. She is a great singer, you know. I think that she doesn't really get enough props for that because she does have a really nice voice. I think the production on this album was slick, actually probably better than the first album production wise, but it's just the lyrics and what she's talking about to me is just not really any substance there. That's just my opinion. And for those that don't know, she is on tour right now with Keisha Cole, so that ought to be a very interesting show. Guys, I suggest you don't go to it. Don't even take your wives or your girlfriends to it, because chances are you might get a brick thrown at your head from Keisha Cole or K. Michelle. So stay at home. All right, so thanks everyone for tuning in. And those are my thoughts on K. Michelle's new CD, Anybody Wanna Buy a Heart. And again, check out the J. Cole review of his new CD, 2014 Forest Hills Drive. Thanks everyone for tuning in to Music Monday. And I will leave you a hint about tomorrow's post. I'll say this, it's a song from a group that we haven't heard from in a while. And it's a Christmas song, a pretty cool Christmas song, and I'll just leave it at that. I will say it's a group that has resurfaced and released new music for Christmas. Maybe they'll have a new album for us here soon too, who knows. But check that out tomorrow, all at www.poeticexpressions.com. Thanks everyone for tuning in, and have a great Monday.